strong they're going to be on defense in terms of being at full strength and personnel. What's it going to take for them to win the game?
When you look at Ohio State's offense against Minnesota, the one thing that jumped out at you was how athletic they were. I mean, you know, they were just, they had so many big plays on offense. They had five plays of 20 yards or greater that resulted in touchdowns. What that means is they didn't have those multiple play drives that resulted in touchdowns. You didn't see C.J. Stroud have to conduct a 14-play drive and then also execute in the red zone, too, where the windows get to be a little tighter and the throws have to be a little bit more accurate. So if I'm Oregon's defense right now, I want to make sure I do not give up the big play. And let's see if this young quarterback, if he can operate 12, 14-play drives, you know, during the game, because that's what we didn't see in the Minnesota game because they had so many big plays and touchdowns.
Let's take a good look at Iowa and Oregon. They play at Ohio State, UCLA, Washington, and Utah. Unless they improve offensively, they're not going to win the Pac-12. But today, watch out today. They're sneaking in there, and when the game will be closer than the experts think, Oregon close.
I think there's two things that Oregon has to do to compete in this game. Number one, they can't play a ton of man-to-man. They like to play man-to-man. Dez is right. They've got to prevent the big play by playing more zone. You play more zone, your safeties aren't down in run support. Can they hold up against this running game that Ohio State has with a big, massive offensive line without getting – if the Oregon safeties start to get down, you're going to give up big plays on the back end. And then on the other side, I keep saying this, Anthony Brown, the quarterback, transferred over from Boston College. Joe Moorhead, I don't know yet if he has a quarterback like a Trace McSorley, like a guy that can really run that offense that he had with Saquon Barkley at Penn State, Trace McSorley. Because that position is a true point guard, running, throwing, scrambling, just dialing it up. He's going to have to do that today to stay with Ohio State.
A veteran guy with 5,000 yards passing in his career. Now, Adam Rittenberg is now reporting that, as we probably expected from looking at the images, Kayvon Thibodeau, doubtful for that game, still waiting to see about the linebacker Justin Flo, who was Pac-12 Freshman of the Week last week and had 14 tackles. So Thibodeau has certainly been a part of the mainstay in the lead-up to this game. But there are other questions like, can Mikhail Wright cover Chris Olave and Garrett Wilson? Can Haskell Garrett, the Ohio State front seven, stop the quarterback run game with Anthony Brown? All of those are important, but mere undercards, according to Ryan McGee, who says the real matchup in this one, Brutus against the Dunk.
Dots the eye of this national championship win.
Brutus is a proven entity when it comes to winning the big game.
Doug, are you in here? You're late for practice.
A duck versus a nut. By the tail of any team, it is a heavyweight mascot magic. But their climb to the top of this life arc was not a straight line. These contenders are no paper tigers, but they were paper mache.
Brutus Buckeye is a magical creature. He had a very humble beginning. He actually started out a gigantic head, and it was paper mache. Everybody asked me, was it hot in there? And I don't know what was happening.
As we got into the 80s and 90s, he got more mobile. His head took shape, his body took shape. The Hulk Hogan or the head gang started coming in.
The Duck's parabolic rise was partly homemade. A direct descendant of Donald, one game forever altered this Duck.
It was against the Houston Cougars, and it was a close game. We kind of had a discussion about, you know, who scores next. We'll kind of have a little bit of a tip. They score, and he turns around, gets to you, and you're fighting.
Disney decided to drop their affiliation with the Duck. The Duck is not Donald. The Duck is the Duck.
Duck, what do you think the chances are of going into the Horseshoe and shocking the world?
We're talking about Brutus here. Brutus trains every day, he doesn't lose.
the duck. He's cute and fluffy, but he'll throw down if he needs to.
The duck at this point is experienced enough, knows what it takes to win. But he doesn't know what it takes to beat Ohio State. So he's got to do something different.
He's 0-9 against Ohio State.
Don't stop! Don't stop!
He's gone to the wilderness to get his mind right.
You get a chip on your shoulder.
We've been told over and over and over again, we're a flash in the pan program. We wear our fancy uniforms, we biff it on the big game. Prove yourself. And I know that's what the duck wants to do when he goes in the horseshoe.
Can the duck have the right eye to win this mascot?
That's a tough one for Lee.
Yeah, it is.
He's supposed to be conflicted.
No question about it. You know, Brutus is my first love.
Wow.
And he was, and I love him. But my favorite now is the duck. I love the interaction with the duck, riding a motorcycle and all that stuff. The duck is my favorite without a question. Go duck.
Is that a lead for who you're going to pick, or is this just the mascot?
Go duck.
That's the game. That's a little bit of a different story.